Good afternoon, folks, and welcome into our third consolation, last consolation match of the day before we get into our medal games here in the next few hours. We have Manitoba taking to the court for their second game of the afternoon, and Nova Scotia checking in for their last game of the tournament as well. Frog is back in the chair with me. Frog, we saw Ben Power go off for 20 points in the first half last night. Do you think he's in for another hot night this afternoon?
Well, I think that, you know, probably the Manitoba teams, you know, watch that game, and they're probably not going to give him those kinds of looks tonight that he got last night. So they're going to have to look to create a different way to see if they can get him open or get somebody else open.
Manitoba with a hard-fought game against BC this morning.
Yeah, tough game this morning for Manitoba against another young developing team that's just a little bit farther ahead in their development than this Manitoba team. But this game, another opportunity for this Manitoba team to continue to learn and grow and get games experience that they'll use in the next quad.
Here we go. Manitoba wins the tip. And Josh Brown, who put together a complete effort this morning, will control it. Gets the screen from Wilton. Can't hit the shot. Just out of the reach of Kayla McKinnon. That's Teo Rock getting a start. Over. Inside, dumped off to Thévenot, and that'll be three in the lane.
Yeah, just a little bit too long. So the opening possession, Spencer Lambert, great job getting a pick on the extended Nova Scotia defender. Needs to just hold it for a second, release, and then communicate his release, and he'll get that ball inside.
Ben Power trapped down on the end line. Up on Lambert's wheel.
Yeah, right off the bat, Manitoba starting to extend, particularly on Jack Sampson. They want to keep his height out of the key. That means that Nova Scotia is going to have to look to pick to get him open and their teammates.
Jack Sampson gives it to Ben Power. He'll work to the other side of the floor. Catches on the move. Sealed off. We'll heave it up, no good.
So right off the bat, we could see the pressure on Ben Power when he had the ball. And so for Nova Scotia to get him open, they're going to have to come and pick for him, then swing the ball.
Here comes Thévenot across the court. Stevens takes a big knock and goes down.
Foul on Manitoba number four, Josh Brown. First personal foul, second team foul.
Jordan hit the deck hard there.
Yeah, good aggressive defense by Kayla McKinnon. She came up, got her axle on the caster, that Manitoba offensive player, stopped that movement, and that's what sort of triggered everything else. That's why it's so important for young players to learn how to keep space and movement with the ball. That means when you're dribbling, you want to keep about 6 inches of space from that defensive player. Even if you have to turn away from the basket to create space, space is more important.
So Justin will pop up holding his left wrist. I think he got it caught underneath. Matt Budgel will come in and take his place.
Yeah, Justin's brother, Jordan, more than willing to get in and take his brother's playing time, I'm sure.
Sampson has a cutting. Budgel finds him, rights himself, can't get the roll. They'll stay Manitoba ball.
So some pressure up court by Nova Scotia, something we haven't seen a whole lot of.
They try to get back. Budgell picked out of the play. Inside, dumped, Thévenot, no good.
Yeah, key thing now for Manitoba is to recognize those defenders that are up court pressuring and then pick those defenders to try to create some numbers advantages as they attack offensively.
Thévenot at the free throw line. First one is all good. Second one up. That one's in as well. Zipped inside, Budgell underneath, draws the foul.
And Manitoba is coming back. They're a little bit sluggish coming back in defensive transition. And as a result, as they got back, they weren't quite where they wanted to be as the Nova Scotia players attacked them. And so they weren't in position, weren't organized. That opened up some of those gaps. And Matt Budgell saw that gap and cut on that opening.
And a quick timeout here for Manitoba.
Yeah, it looks like Coach Jaworski's talking about how when they come back, they've got to push harder, see the court. That gives them a little bit more time to identify threats in transition and see how that Nova Scotia team's attacking, then adjust their chair position to stop that initial attack and some of those initial cuts. He's probably also talking a little bit about some pressure that maybe they didn't anticipate from Nova Scotia and how to take advantage of that. Get those picks in the open court, run that back pick, and don't release off that back pick until there's space to release up court.
So they will come in for the free throws. First free throw is off the mark. Second one up and good as well. Down goes Lambert to the block, gets it ripped away. Loose with the ball there. Brown recovers, 7 on the shot clock. Got to look around, throws it inside. Lambert couldn't make a play on it.
Yeah, a little slow to develop. So there's a pick for him, and what he's got to do is he's got to explode off that pick, and he kind of coasted off that pick. There we go. We see Manitoba defense starting higher and tighter together. There's the adjustment coming out of the timeout. Coach Jaworski making sure that they do a better job starting higher and tighter.
Jack Sampson sealed off. McKinnon inside, can't get the roll, should go to the free throw line.
Good look by Caleb McKinnon on the offside. You can see Spencer Lambert staying extended on the Nova Scotia matchup. So they're going to guard those threats for Nova Scotia way outside and make it really difficult, force Nova Scotia to come and set picks to get their teammates open.
Kayla just passed the line. So side out here for Manitoba, 2-1.
You can see Manitoba already should have 2 picks.
Lambert working, has an easy lane to the cup and puts it in.
Yeah, great seal by Thomas Thévenot to get Lambert, Spencer Lambert into the key that time.
Power inside, hard off glass, nothing there. Butchel knocks that off Josh's chin.
Yeah, so we were just talking about how important it is to keep space. You saw Josh Brown turn into the Nova Scotia defender that locks him down and allows him to reach. Turn away in that situation, you keep space. The Nova Scotia defender has to keep his hands down on his wheels and can't reach while he's pushing his chair.
Wilton chasing it down, stays in bounds. And they'll reset. Nice hustle play there. Dumped inside. Thévenot, there you go.
Yeah, great job. Thévenot on the cut to the basket. Josh Brown has his head up, and he saw the cut, so he'd get the ball to Thomas's right hand, too. Not his left hand, right hand, which is the open hand.
Now Manitoba extending their defense up full court. Budgel works through it. Zipped into power. McKinnon's wide open on the other side of the floor. They don't see her, and it's turned over.
Yeah, we've seen this before where the Manitoba team comes out maybe a little bit sluggish, and then they put that press on to get them kick-started a little bit. And so that might be what they're doing here. Get them after that first game this morning. They might be a little bit sluggish, a little bit tired. Gets their engine running a little bit higher if they come out with that press to open.
Lambert kicks over. Thévenot on the block, waits. No good. Josh Brown collecting the rebound and throws it up for a foul.
Yeah, so we saw two baseline cuts to get the Manitoba players open. One on the ball side and the shot cut. As a result, on the other side, the baseline cut gives them the offensive rebound. Always, always deny baseline. Always force your matchup to go higher.
Josh Brown's first free throw is good. Second one up and knocks it down. Brown, big collision there, trying to get the steal.
So that's concerning. He picks up his third foul, and we're not even 5 minutes into the game. Also, Josh is going to have to take care of that.
Manitoba in the bonus now, too. So what do they do now without their initiator and best player out there?
Yeah, somebody else has to step up. They're going to have to take on some different roles. What will be particularly important right now is that they communicate on the court. Josh communicates a lot. He really kind of coordinates their defense, helps them be patient on offense. So somebody else is going to have to do that on the court.
Eight-1 Manitoba lead. Beth Johnson will run point here. Beth looking for a cutter. Nobody there. Gives it back. Thévenot maneuvers inside, switches hands, can't finish. Teo's got a push there. Samson tries to go past him. Nice cutoff, and a little too much heat on that pass.
Yeah, so they're staying with their press, Manitoba is. That means that what Nova Scotia is going to have to do, one, they have to keep space and move them with the ball. But now they have to look to pick off ball, and that's where they'll get their openings. They don't want to get into a race where they're trying to beat people down in one-on-one cuts all the time.
Beth Johnson will collect it. Throws it forward, picked off by Power. There's Sampson. She comes out on him, stops him. That's a good foul to take there with an open lane finishing.
Yeah, so we see the same thing again. We saw the Manitoba player go into the Nova Scotia defender, and that changed the passing lane. Even though the Nova Scotia defender didn't get a piece of the ball, they changed the passing lane and put the ball in the air and opened up the opportunity for their teammate to steal it.
So Samson will get a couple of free throws. First one off the back of the rim, no good.
Yeah, Jack Sampson is the son of the head coach, Steve Sampson.
Jack shot, in and out. Good job by Tao, letting it run out of bounds. And Justin Stevens back in after taking that fall, so he's all good. Beth looking at the elbow. Has room if she wants to use it. Flips it over to Spencer Lambert. He's gonna go too far. Budgel getting up the court. He's got a wide open lane. Oh, left it short.
Great look. That came out of a cross read from Justin Stevens, who went to try to cross pick. The two defenders had to turn him and stop him. That opened up that cut to the basket for Matt Budgel.
Lambert kicking. Deveneau makes the grab. Tried to dump it into Raw. Too many arms.
Yeah, tough read. The help defender was coming over for Nova Scotia. So what Thomas wants to read is, where did that defender come from? And that's where his open teammate is. That's the spot to go.
And checking in now for Winnipeg, we got number 13, Ryan Long Sox Bolesky.
Yes, Long Sox. I understand that's a nickname that's been given to him during this game by his teammates.
Get those stirrups up like a member of the 70s Oakland A's.
There you go.
10-1 Manitoba lead. And a big hit. Ben Power on the collision. So 10-1 here, midway through the first, and Coach Sampson will use a timeout.
So Manitoba's tightened up their full court defense. They're getting up on the Nova Scotia chairs. So Nova Scotia's got to make sure they create space and movement, don't run into them, and then they need to cross. They need to not just go in straight lines up the court, but they need to cross as they're moving up the court. And that'll create picking opportunities. We saw that with Justin Stevens, where he went to cross inside the three-point line. That opened up a cut for his teammate to the basket. The same principle applies in the open court, where you have space and movement with the ball, and then you cross off ball to create opportunities. So nice adjustment by Manitoba to get up, be more aggressive, getting a chair on a chair. Now Nova Scotia has to make the corresponding adjustment on the other side of the coin.
Really struggling to get the shot dropping.
Good to see from Manitoba, with Josh Brown out, to see them respond as a unit and come together and tighten up on defense. There's that extended defender. What Thomas Thibodeau needs to do is just stop. Just wait there and let his teammates come and pick. Don't try to fight that. Use that against Nova Scotia.
Lambert will look around. Drive inside. Pushes McKinnon off the block. Second one up. In and through.
Yeah, nice touch that time by Spencer. We've seen him as the tournament's going early in the tournament. He struggled inside, and now he's starting to get his rhythm a bit and take the time in those shots.
...12-1. McKinnon over the half. Finds the cutter. Power, can he finish? Yes.
Yeah, a little bit of miscommunication in the open court as Matthew Wilton rotated off of Ben Powers and the switch happened for Thomas Thibodeau to get him, and a little bit of miscommunication there.
And a turnover, it'll go back the way of Nova Scotia. There's Power, comes out of the chair, and that'll just be a turnover.
Yeah, there's that spot. He turns in, rides up on the wheel, falls over, and he has the space to do it. He just needs to keep space, turn out. He'll keep that defender extended, and they can still pick that person.
Devineaux back to Spencer Lambert, loses it for a second, gets it back. Tries to keep the handle, fumbling with it. Puts it up and can't get it to go. Outlet to Budgell, makes the catch over his shoulder. And they're trying to wait for a foul call that didn't come.
Great hustle by Ryan Longtalk Spileski to get back into the play after Budgell was going full court. Great hustle play.
Beth Johnson just over half. She's got a lot of space. Weaves her way in. Tried to make that extra pass. Got her hand caught. First free throw up off the back of the iron. Second one. Gets it to go. Nice recovery after getting her hand jammed in there.
So here we can see that Manitoba pressure up court.
Collision there, loose ball. Wilton almost saves it.
Yeah, good pressure up court, but what they've got to do is they've got to go under picks when they do see them. Nova Scotia doing a good job getting the pick that time. Now Manitoba's going to have to adjust and go under those picks and see them.
Power. Working the baseline. Johnson getting her hand in there. She's trapped now. They switch it. Sampson gets the roll and the finish.
Beautiful pick and roll by Nova Scotia. Absolutely beautiful.
Here comes Lambert. The bunch of room. Takes his time. Doesn't get enough lift on it. Over the top. Sampson swiped away. Can't be loose with the ball like that. Lob pass up to Ben Power. And there goes Sampson. Ah, not enough on it.
Nice cross pick by Spencer Lambert. And the picking machine, Matthew Wilton, getting another back pick.
Takes Sampson out of the play. Beth pulled it back over to Spencer Lambert. Nice dish, but he was in the lane for too long.
So they've got a mismatch post up down low. What they need to do is go up hard on the ball, pressure it so there isn't an easy pass down to Jack Sampson down in the low block.
Stevens about to go over again. Got it away to Power inside. Sampson's shot is good.
Yeah, great read by Jack Sampson to go post early. The corresponding read by Manitoba is to go hard up court and don't let the ball get down into a position where it can be passed inside.
So a good fight back here. At one point, Nova Scotia was down 12-1 and now cut the lead down to 6. And they'll call Thévenot for losing control of that back wheel. So 9.5 seconds. McKinnon fumbles it. And they want to have a chance for a play now. Sampson just heaves it down the court to be safe. So end of one, Manitoba up 6, 13-7.
Yeah, so Manitoba's starting to put some pressure up court, trying to get themselves going a bit. They've got to make sure when they go up court, they put a chair on a chair. They get an axle on a caster, stop chairs, get a hand up to stop that ball from moving up the court. Nova Scotia has to, they can't go up in vertical lines. They've got to cross to be a post for the ball, and they got to keep space and movement on the ball, and then they got to pick off ball. Those are the types of things that are going to create opportunities for them. On the offensive end, Manitoba, you know, Nova Scotia putting some pressure up court. They're giving Manitoba opportunities for back picks. Manitoba has to take advantage of those. Set that back pick, attack up court, and let that picker release into space if they're going to get to the rim. Meanwhile, Josh Brown has to patiently sit on the sidelines.
And you saw kind of the Manitoba offense stop working once Josh came out. Without him, they need much more from Thévenot or Lambert as a creator.
Well, with Josh, what Manitoba has is they have a consistent outside shooter. So when things aren't quite settling out on offense and they're not able to get that inside look, Josh has in previous games hit those outside shots to keep things going for the Manitoba offense. Without him out there, their outside shooters are more inconsistent. And so Nova Scotia gets a chance to try to pack it in a little bit more and just deny inside cuts and make Manitoba shoot from outside just a little bit more as well.
So about to get back underway here. Start the second quarter. Bernard Rossello will check in for Manitoba. And McKinnon, not sure she knew she was so close to the line.
Yeah, I know. I've noticed that some of the players have gotten a little bit confused with the way the lines are right around half court, with the dark blue, black, and dark blue all around each other.
Thévenot weaves into the paint. Has Rossello, doesn't give it to him, and it goes out of bounds.
Yeah, it's interesting. So Spencer Lambert had his right hand in the air, but the pass was what I would call a left-handed pass, a pass to his left hand. So he has to catch with the other hand. You have to be able to catch with both hands and not just use one hand all the time. In the same way, you have to pass with both hands.
Scotia number 6, Justin Stevens picks up a foul there. First team foul. Lambert will inbound. Cross court, Thévenot's shot, no good.
You can see Nova Scotia pack it in on the back pick that time, not giving Manitoba an opportunity to get to the hoop.
Power. Over to Justin Stevens. Has no room, gives it back. They'll need a deep one. Almost hit it, was online, but short.
So there we can see the Manitoba defense extended and Nova Scotia having difficulty setting those picks. They're trying to pick on ball and some of their pick mechanics are a little bit off. They're turning, the Manitoba defenders are facing that pick when it's coming. So if you see a pick coming, you go under it, it's an easy read. So you want to turn that defender so that they can't see it coming. It makes it a harder read for the defender to collapse in.
D. Osmond, number three, checks in for Nova Scotia. In for Justin Stevens for her first action of the day. That foul will go on Bernard Rossello. Pass to Osmond, she can't handle it. And Bolesky just wraps that one up with Samson's hand coming over the top.
There's that technical foul that we've seen the officials consistently call. So Jack Sampson starting to fall out of his chair, puts his foot down, and the officials are saying that's a physical advantage. Not allowed to touch the floor, so it's a technical foul. Aggressive play by Jack Sampson, reaching in, you know, trying to get the jump ball or the steal. Just fell over, or started to fall over in the process.
So Thévenot will take the technical foul shot. Banks at home. ...14-7 the Manitoba lead.
Like this, Bernard already with that pick on Jordan Stevens. Nova Scotia's got to come in, bump him a little bit, help their teammate get back in on defense so they can play with five and not a man out.
Thévenot at the elbow, down low, Lambert, shot up, way too long. Said Wilton gets it slapped away by Jack Sampson there at the right place at the right time. Lambert, ball zipping around now. Rossello sets himself, shoots, scores.
Great look, and I love how Bernard Rossello has been really getting square to the hoop, make good decisions. He's getting better and better at hitting that shot as the tournament's gone on.
Osmond trapped, and she's called for the travel.
Yeah, so some early turnovers by Nova Scotia in this that are sort of stopping that momentum that they had to finish off the first quarter.
McKinnon picked out by Rossello. Thévenot working the back of Power, creates a little space, can't hit it. And Osmond wasn't ready for that pass either. Recovered by Spencer Lambert. He'll get inside, zip back, pushed out. Now he gets down to the block, and halfway down and out.
Yeah, right there.
Osmond collects that one to McKinnon. Power now, gets to the elbow, cuts. Osmond right there to pick it up. She goes up, draws a foul.
So one of the things Manitoba's doing, you can see Ryan Bolesky is going all the way back on defense. So really there's only four up. for Manitoba. That means there's somebody free for Nova Scotia, either as a post or a picker. Nova Scotia has to identify who that person is and attack through that person, either by posting the ball to them and letting them bring the ball up the court, or by having that person go and set a pick for somebody else off ball.
So Jack Sampson will come out. They get number 24, Liam Murray, into the game. And Jason Dross, number 23, will check in as well.
Right away, see Matthew Wilton looking to pick during the dead ball. See that Manitoba, or the Nova Scotia defense packed in, daring Manitoba to try to shoot from outside.
Evan O makes good on that attempt. 18-8 the score. Power makes his move.
Shot up. No good.
Put back by McKinnon. In and out.
Nice crossing and picking by Manitoba in the open court.
And it gets wide open shot for Thevenot, too strong.
Yeah, he just rushed it. He had time there. He's got a second to take a breath and take a quality shot.
Here's Liam Murray. Shot clock down. D'Osmond trapped, calls for help. Liam comes. Shot inside, and they'll get him for an offensive foul. And Coach Sampson will take a timeout after that one.
Yeah, so Nova Scotia packing it in on defense. You can see that help defender in the middle. That'll help if somebody does cut. But they look like they're going to be willing to give up an outside shot and prevent those cuts from inside. And Manitoba looks like they're struggling. They're struggling to find somebody who has a rhythm from outside with Josh Brown sitting on the bench. So the way for Nova Scotia or Manitoba to attack that Nova Scotia defense, it'll be to set a pick in the backcourt to pick out one of those defenders to open up a bigger space so the defense isn't as quite as tight, or to move that help defender in the middle and open up a gap at the elbow. So it'll be one of those two things that
I'll send you a note about the play
that they're going to want to do. At the other end, Manitoba continue with that pressure outside. Don't let Nova Scotia easily move up the court, but go under on those picks.
So Thevenot will bring it up.
Yeah, you can just see Nova Scotia's daring them to try to shoot from outside. They're really not going to go out. You can see the help defender, Ben Powers, rotating in the middle just to make sure there's no space for a ball side cut, and then they force the outside shot.
Osmond collects the board. She'll bring it up. And losing control, they're going into Matt Wilton.
Great read by Matt Wilton to slide out in front and quickly take away position. D got caught with her head down in the dribble, and he took advantage of that.
And as we've seen on both ends, it is not easy to move Matt Wilton as a screener or as a defender.
No. He is great at getting position, getting an axle on a caster. And even though he's a smaller player, you can't move a person who's got position. Not easily.
Thevenot looking around. Gets it to Lambert on that wing. No call foul, I think, on Jason Dross there.
Yeah, I'm looking over at Steve Sampson, the coach from Nova Scotia. He's smiling. He's like, no, I want you. Jason, I want you to stay in. I know you're anxious. I don't think you can get that ball, but just patience and stay in. Jason's smiling right now. I think he heard Coach Sampson talking to him.
And in the bonus, so Matt Wilton gets to shoot a free throw. First one off to the right side. Second one up. Can't get the rim.
Yeah, Matthew was doing track and came over and started doing a little bit of basketball. And I was chatting with him in a camp in the summertime, and he really enjoys basketball. I think he likes the thinking part of it, the strategy and everything like that. And he's a bright kid, so it's a great fit strategically for him.
You can tell watching him, too, that he picks up strategies very well.
Yeah.
And a foul on Rosello coming out, so baseline inbounds for Nova Scotia.
That's a tough place to pass. Kayla McKinnon double teamed inside, and D Osmond tries to go inside to her. He's got to find where that open matchup is for him.
Thibodeau comes by and intercepts it. Now we're off to the races. 2-on-1, 3-on-1.
Great crossing in the open court by Manitoba.
Leads to a layup for Lambert.
Really good job turning that Nova Scotia defender, and then they end up attacking the back of that Nova Scotia defender with a cut.
Murray takes a dribble, looking around. Power up at the top. We'll go the other way.
See Manitoba, they're picking those extended defenders. That opens up just a little bit more space for their attack.
And that will be a travel on Thibodeau. 20-8 here, just under halfway through the second quarter. Murray, collision, no calls, and it'll go Manitoba ball.
So it's not a bad place for Liam Murray to attack. What he just needs to do, bounce stop just before that defender, because he had a height mismatch and he could have taken a short jump shot over top of the Manitoba defender.
Thibodeau. Lambert out of his reach.
And you can really see Nova Scotia packing it in. They're really not going to come out right now.
Especially without Josh Brown being on the court. You'll take your chances.
Takes a lot of discipline on the part of Nova Scotia to be that close to somebody holding the ball but not go out on him.
McKinnon trapped to Osmond. She can't make the grab. Lucky bounce. Crossover. Ben Cower. Dross is wide open underneath. Lambert comes across late. Gets the contest.
Tough spinning shot to hit. Good job finding the open teammate down low by Nova Scotia, though.
Lambert gets to the lane. Rosello takes a dribble, sets himself, just a little strong. Loose ball. Wilton recovers. No reset on the shot clock. Now they do get the 14. Lambert at the elbow, short. Into the hands of Drost. And now Murray can work. Kayla McKinnon makes the grab. Little high for Osmond.
So it takes a little bit more when a team's going to pack it in like Nova Scotia's doing. Great discipline, great decision on their part, make Manitoba proof from outside. It's going to take a little bit more discipline on the part of Manitoba to move defenders so that gaps open up.
Lambert can't handle that one.
There's that gap. One of the defenders, Caleb McKinnon, got picked out. It opens up a bit more space in the defense for one of the Manitoba players to get to the rim.
Liam Murray says, I didn't touch it.
Looks like the official agrees with him.
We'll stay Nova Scotia ball. Dross is open on a cutter. Power finds him. Nice catch with one hand. Extra pass to Osman. Just can't get it to go.
Good look inside. You can see Manitoba trying to pick in the open court to open up some of that space right now.
There's Rossello. Gets it back. Knocks it down. And I don't know why. We've seen Rossello make shots all week. Nobody closes out on him.
I know. I said it before. I love how he takes his time. He's square to the hoop. He never takes a bad shot. And he's starting to hit more and more of them. And that's what Manitoba needs right now. They need somebody who can hit a couple shots from outside to pull that Nova Scotia defense out.
22-8, they stretch their lead. Osman on the baseline, sealed off. Looking around, Ben makes the catch behind his back and then zips it to Murray. That would have been a little showtime.
Yeah, that would have been the play of the week if that had gone through.
Pass to Raw. Off glass, can't get it to go. This crossover from Thévenot. Rossello, he's got space. Give the shooter the shot. Hesitation, he drains another one.
He looked like he was almost going to pass it off and then... And then I think Spencer said, no, take that. And
you're
sure
open.
Enough, Bernard went up. One bounce, boom, in it goes.
Bernard having a great half here.
Oh, Manitoba with some really smart young players out here making some really good reads, really good decisions, very focused.
35 seconds left in the half. Osman's shot up.
Great pick by D. Osman to get open.
There goes Manitoba. Be a couple free throws.
Nice little pick and roll by Bernard Rossello. So that's one of the things that young players get really wrapped up in trying to cut to the basket. Got to get myself open. The best way to get open is to set a pick because the person who gets open in a pick and roll more often than not is the person who set the pick. Mm-hmm. So those young players that are out there wanting to play wheelchair basketball, wanting to get opportunities to score, one of the best things you can do is learn how to be a great picker.
And that one's batted out by Lambert.
You can see Coach Jaworski telling his guys to get right up.
And Murray makes a quick play. McKinnon can't make the grab. So Thévenot, oh yeah, he's going to launch. Just short, so end of the first half, Manitoba leading 24-8.
Yeah, Manitoba's done a really good job putting pressure up court. They've made it difficult for Nova Scotia to get up court. Nova Scotia, they got to keep space and movement when they're attacking up court, cross and pick. when they've done that, they've gotten people open, or when Manitoba hasn't made contact with the chairs. The other end of the court, Nova Scotia's defense, they've packed it in. It's been tough for Manitoba to generate scoring opportunities inside with Josh Brown out with early foul trouble. Bernard Rosello's come in. He's hit a couple of shots. That's something they're going to have to do, is go to him if they don't have Josh Brown come back. And they got to figure out how they're going to get the gaps they need. One of the ways is going to be backpicking. Other ways are going to be some more disciplined movement with the ball and without the ball in the front court to move those tight defenders around.
Second half in 10 minutes. Second half about to get underway here. Manitoba leading 24-8. First shot is good.
Yeah, there's that tight Nova Scotia defense trying to make Manitoba prove from outside. Josh Brown back in right away, makes his presence known with that outside shot.
So Josh Brown back in for Manitoba, as you mentioned. Had those three fouls in the first 5 minutes, didn't come back out. Ozzen's shot long.
So as we mentioned, one of the things that Manitoba wants to do, they want to pick Nova Scotia defenders that are extended. That'll open up gaps and get them to the rim. As good as Josh is as an outside shooter, they still don't want to try to, you know, win with the outside shot.
Brown's layup in.
Yeah, right away, pick defender out, gap in the defense, go to the hoop. Yeah, for the next game, I think Paul Bowes will be joining you. I think outside right now he's busy signing autographs.
I know.
That might be delaying him coming into the gym.
The fans just swarm Bozy wherever he goes.
Everybody has their cross to bear.
Ben Power will control it at the top of the circle. Sampson collects. Inside, Jason Dross makes the catch over Beth Johnson, puts it up and in.
Nice. Little gap at the elbow. Jason saw it, cut into that gap. Jack Sampson has the head up, drops it in perfectly for Jason so he can gather himself to shoot.
There goes Beth. She's got space. Tries to attack that hole, and Sampson's reach just outdoes her.
Yeah, Bernard Rosello had a back pick up at the top of the key. He needs to call that he's got that and communicate that so that his teammates know how to attack appropriately to give him that gap.
Drost, second look in a row, can't make it. Brown weaves in. And he's got to make up for all the scoring he couldn't do in the first half. Does it right there.
Great seal by Spencer Lambert to get Josh Brown in for the wide open layup.
Brown, free throw is good. So he completes the and one. And that one goes long. Will be Manitoba basketball. And Coach Sampson will take a timeout.
Yeah, right away, Coach Sampson recognizing that they're having some difficulty. One, up court, they're getting picked out. And two, they've got to identify that Josh Brown's back in. Just probably going to remind them about threat identification, making sure that they don't jump out on the wrong players, stay in tight. But now he's going to have to make an adjustment in the half court. So if Josh Brown's going to get that ball on the wing and they're going to go out on him, that means a help defender is going to have to rotate, probably from the middle of that Nova Scotia defense. That means something's going to open up high offside, and the Manitoba players are going to have to identify that part. So Steve Sampson, I've had a chance to room with him on the road and spent a lot of time with him traveling over the years. One of his little quirks, that when he goes to Tim Hortons and he orders a coffee, he always has to have chocolate milk put in his coffee. So at our training center, I think that the ladies there recognize him and they stock up on chocolate milk when they see him coming in for a week of training.
I've heard of chocolate milk in the ice cap, but never in the coffee.
Yep. And Sammy gets a very large cup of coffee, so there's a lot of chocolate milk that they have to stock up on.
How many bathroom trips per cup of coffee? Brown looks around, has some space, in and out. Beth Johnson setting a pick there. Rossello, Power got a piece of it. Shot goes in.
Oh, Josh Brown somehow finds a narrow window after that offensive rebound.
And Josh now crashing, nearly got another steal. And that'll be an 8-second call.
Okay, so Manitoba putting pressure up court, in particular staying on their matchups, mm-hmm. letting the ball go over to other ball handlers and staying on threats up court. And so Nova Scotia's going to have to come back and pick for their teammates to get them open.
Brown settles himself down. Another one. Josh is hot after coming in here.
We could see that upcourt pressure causing some ball handling problems for Nova Scotia.
They're going to have to find an answer here.
Okay, two out. Now we look for the gaps to open up a little bit bigger in transition for Manitoba.
Brown has all the space on the roll. Lambert, oh, you got to use the glass there. Up, McKinnon. She stopped in her tracks. They break it. Drost.
Nice job moving the ball by Nova Scotia. Great job.
Into McKinnon. Her shot's up and good.
Excellent. Space and movement all the way up. Pass to the open person posting for the ball. Cut to open space. Great fundamental basketball by Nova Scotia on that possession to break that upcourt pressure.
Josh Brown spins away. Another shot is good. Josh is feeling it.
Yeah, he's gained a lot of confidence from this tournament.
And now when he goes into these training sessions with a bunch of high-level players with you and working out, how does a tournament like this where he's been the sole leader help going into that?
Well, I think he's going to keep, we really want to build off this confidence and really talk about, hey, you could do it. You know, all the things are the same things. It's just you're doing them against faster, bigger, stronger players. And I think that's one of the challenges when an athlete comes out to our National Academy to train. They come from an environment where they're the best. And they come out, and all of a sudden, they're sort of starting over. And everybody else is better than them. And they experience some difficulty. There's a lot of challenges. And but that's part of it. The ones that understand that, and they embrace that challenge, and they attack it, those are the ones that are the most successful. Because that's what challenge does. Challenge can make you better if you approach it the right way.
Free throw from Jack Sampson is off. Brown to Beth Johnson. She'll move forward. There she goes. Inside, Wilton's shot no good. Lambert's second effort, too short. And out of bounds, it'll go the other way.
So Nova Scotia's got to replicate what they did a couple of possessions ago. They've got to keep space and movement, pass the ball, cut to open space, pass the ball.
Sampson just had to throw it, stay in bounds, ton of traffic, and it'll go the other way.
Yeah, your first read to break this press, to break this upcourt pressure, isn't to take the ball and dribble it. It's to take the ball and look for a teammate to headman the ball to. Even if that pass only moves 8 feet forward, it still moves the ball forward.
Rossello has a little bit of room if he wants to take a shot. Afraid of Samson's contest, doesn't matter, shoots over him. Rebound loose.
Yeah, Jack Sampson almost daring Bernard to take that shot.
And up court to Dross, but it'll be an offensive foul in the backcourt.
Number 11, Jack Sampson, that's his fourth.
So Nova Scotia did a good job breaking the press before that. They have to get back to that piece, pay attention to what they did, and have the discipline to say, oh, I'm going to cut to space. Oh, I'm going to cut to space.
Josh Brown shot off. Beth Johnson right there for the board. Pushed it a little far.
Jack's got his head up. He's looking for that deep teammate.
Marcello almost got a steal.
And there's that pass and cut to open space.
McKinnon, great job staying in bounds. Just couldn't quite save it.
Yeah, almost up on two wheels there. Almost saved it and just kind of just a smidge out of bounds. Let's watch and see where the gap can open up in the defense right now with that player picked out. There we see on the offside as a defensive player rotated from the elbow.
Josh just takes it away and finishes. Power. Up court.
There's your space. Space and movement with the ball.
And they get it
across.
Pass
to an open cutter.
And a nice play by Beth Johnson to seal off McKinnon.
But you could see Jack Sampson in the open court, instead of pushing into that defender, turned away to keep space. Mm-hmm. That allowed him to keep his head up, read the court. There's no pressure on the ball. And see that cutter on the offside.
Josh Brown at the top of the circle. Looks around. He'll pull. Nothing there. Run in for his own rebound. And that's just Nova Scotia getting caught ball watching right there.
Yeah. If you're gonna pack it in and make teams shoot from outside, what you're doing is you're basically saying, we think you're going to miss that shot. So if you think they're going to miss a shot, then you get ready for offensive rebounding.
Spencer Lambert having a tough day trying to finish these off.
There we go, moving the ball up the court. Get space and movement.
Inside, Stevens has McKinnon underneath. She gets there, puts it up, not enough. Here comes Johnson now, stops herself. And that'll be a travel. Leah Murray. Looking around. Power sealed. Looking for help, and they're caught on each other.
Yeah, they got hooked up. Ben Powers' fender got hooked inside Spencer Lambert's wheel, and it looks like he might have actually maybe caught the valve stem and ripped it. So Spencer's got a flat tire now, I think. He's going to have to change that out. It's tough. Each of the chairs has a fender in the front, and that fender's designed to do a couple things. One, to protect the feet, and two, to really fill in some of the gaps so that players don't get hooked up. But every now and then, the fenders bend or some different things. They change the wheel width, and a space opens up, and that's where players end up getting hooked up. And that hook can cause a lot of damage to wheels.
So a quick change for Spencer's wheel. He's back out there. Cross court, Leah Murray will let it go. No good.
So nice job by Manitoba going under, taking away any of the picks or cuts from Nova Scotia and forcing that outside shot. Nova Scotia getting a little bit of a taste of their own medicine there.
Lob pass into Lambert, just can't finish down there.
It's a good look. The defender came out on Josh Brown because he's proved it from outside. And that opened up, that forced the defender to rotate from the other side. That opened up a gap on the other side for Spencer Lambert to cut into.
There's McKinnon, makes the grab. She's knocked down.
I love how hard she fights. Kayla just goes at it. Every push is a hard push. She's going to scrap the whole way.
Puts her whole body into every push, too. Power shot in and out. Leah Murray pops back up. Beth Johnson racked across the arm.
Yeah, Josh Brown was breaking up the court. He yelled, send it. She was just winding up to get it up court to him.
Up to Rosello, stops at the free throw line. Can't get the roll. Josh Brown, put back, no. Off the wheel. Stay Manitoba ball.
So now we've seen that tight defense is forcing some outside shots. That's good, that's what Nova Scotia wants. Now they have to add the box out to it. I think Coach Jaworski is trying to communicate to his guys how he wants to run that inbounds play. Mm-hmm.
During this check of the clock. Wilton sets the pick. Brown will have to move. Dump inside, Beth Johnson, her shot no good.
Nice job by Josh Brown, reading the other side of the court. So often they get focused on the ball side.
Ben Power looking around. 30 seconds to go in the quarter. That shot off. Powers look no good. Leah Murray sneaking in. Can't finish. His third effort. No. Tips it around. It's going to go out of bounds. So 10 seconds left to get a look.
Yeah, they're extending. Manitoba's extending on Ben Powers, and he's trying to almost fight that by trying to beat them by just pushing. And what he needs to do is use his teammates to pick for him. It's a more efficient way of attacking.
So 41-12 here at the end of the third quarter.
So Josh Brown came back in and right away made his presence known. You know, that's the answer. So Nova Scotia had done a great job. They packed it in. Manitoba had struggled to finish the second half. They came out in the third quarter. Josh Brown added a little bit of that outside offense that started to pull the Nova Scotia defenders out. Manitoba picked in the open court. That opened up some more gaps. And Nova Scotia Manitoba combined to hit some outside shots and then also get to the rim. I still think Nova Scotia wants to stay tight on defense. Maybe try to push that screen on Josh Brown's side out just a little bit farther. Make him shoot from one shooting zone. Then make quicker decisions to get their when they go from offense to defense to get back on defense so that they have all five players back. And then against some of the pressure from Manitoba, it's keeping space and movement with the ball, post the ball, then cut to open space to receive a post back. Simple little things in the open court against that pressure.
So last quarter of the tournament for both of these teams. Look to close on a high note with some good execution.
Yeah, you know, Manitoba, keep working on these things. They're getting a chance to see lots of different types of defense. So in practice each day, they go against themselves and they see basically the same kinds of defense each day. Really valuable for a young team now to get exposed to different types of defense and then begin to understand how the principles of offense or the principles of defense apply against different teams. Nova Scotia, same thing. You know, so for them, they play in the Maritime League. They play against the Maritimes, and a lot of those teams play a similar style. They're getting a chance to see something that they don't see a lot, that up-court pressure. And that's showing them how important it is that they attack as a team and how everybody's developed their on-ball skills.
So Power collects it off the inbound. Shot is up and off to the right.
And we can see Nova Scotia hustling back now, trying to get everybody in on defense. They can play that tight defense, but maybe push that screen out just a little bit farther on the side that Josh Brown goes to.
That one is off.
Yeah, Thomas Thibodeau. He cut on the baseline. He cut on the back of Jack Sampson. Jack got caught facing the wrong way.
That's Julia McKinnon into the game, Kayla's sister. She puts it up. Brown. Sees her help, throws it across, second effort, no good. Josh's third, nope. The fourth chance, rolls out, the fifth, no. There will not be a sixth.
No, some great looks, they just have to take that breath that we've talked about. Nice job by Josh Brown initially having his head up and seeing his teammate Thomas Thibodeau cutting on the offside to get in.
Jack will spin the other way off that. Spins into the shot, in and out.
So Jack Sampson, he's charging the rebound at times, and that's putting him out of position to get back on defense. Nova Scotia really needs him to get back on defense more than they need him to contest a rebound who's already got the ball.
Shot from Long Sox Bolesky, no good. Sampson lost the handle on it.
Yeah, just a little bounce stop there. Keeps space from the defender. See the defender for Nova Scotia rotate over. The offside's open if Manitoba can see that.
Beveno shot off. And Sampson's handle now getting him in trouble a couple times. Ross stripped the other way, gets it back. Shot from Teo, no good.
Yeah, that's that piece where he looked to dribble first instead of pass. And he's got some teammates up court. But those teammates, as they go up court, they've got to look behind themselves on offense and see that he needs a post, stop, and come back to the ball.
Sampson kick. McKinnon calls for it. Has it tipped? And that's Kendra McClellan, number 13 in the game.
So we've got all five in for Nova Scotia, and you can see how tight they are on defense, and they're not even going to jump Josh Brown right now.
Who knocks down the shot? McClellan into Sampson. Shot up and in.
Nice look. I like the way Jack Sampson took a moment to square himself to the basket instead of taking a shot where he's out of balance or out of alignment.
Cross court, Wall. We'll take a look at it. Too strong.
Nice hustle and rebound by Kayla McKinnon. Yeah, Josh Brown is extended on Jack Sampson. Jack's got to stop and call for that pick. He can back up, try to create space, and then try to do a facing cut, but that's not going to be as efficient a way to attack. An easier way to is to use his teammates to help him.
Sampson, the cut, the finish. He'll go to the free throw line.
You know, as I've watched all the players through the course of the tournament, watching, they come in a little bit rough, and gradually as the tournament goes on, they begin to smooth out and begin to, you know, learn and grow from this. Jack Sampson's an example of that, where I've seen his shot mechanics a little bit unsteady at the beginning of the tournament. He's gradually settled in, and as the tournament has gone on, he's taking better and better shots, and he's understanding his role and the height that he's got to use out there, and he's taking getting some better scoring opportunities.
Power working. 5 left to go in this one. And that'll go off the top of the glass. Should be a shot clock violation. Yeah, it is.
So it looks like Nova Scotia is trying to cross and set picks. The Manitoba defenders are anticipating that, and they're going and they're overplaying that pick. So what Nova Scotia has to read is what we call the complementary read. That's the read that opens up when your first read's taken away. And a lot of times, that's going to be a pick going the other way or a cut going the other way. And so the Nova Scotia offensive players have to recognize that pick's now getting taken away. They have a pick going the other way or a cut going the other way, the complementary read.
And in goes 7-0, can't finish.
Yeah, great look because of Ryan Longsocks Bolesky's seal.
Out of McKinnon's hands, loose, scramble. Teo picks it up.
Love Teo's hustle. Like, he's going to fight every single possession.
Nice feed. Long socks can't get a handle. Brown, why not? In and out. Follow, good.
Great follow by Thomas Thibodeau. To get that, he's reading the cut as soon as that defender turns their back offside so he can be there for an offensive rebound.
McKinnon comes back for it. Vanessa Stevens into the game now, so all 3 Stevens siblings in.
Yeah, that's something you definitely don't see very often, is 3 siblings getting a chance to compete in the sport all at one time.
Beth Johnson comes back for the ball. Gets it across the court. Around, shot, up, off the right. There goes Sampson, picked off.
So good try by Jack Sampson. He kept his head up, looked for his teammate. Just got to let him get it a little bit deeper. And that's where the teammate role comes in and moving that ball up the court. So Jack had his head up. He had space so he could see to make the pass. The next thing is for his teammates to read behind, stop, and come back and post the ball or cross to post the ball. Both are ways that his teammates can control passing lanes and create better passing lanes to be able to move that ball up by passing instead of dribbling. Dribbling is what the defense wants you to do against up-court pressure. They want you to dribble it up the court. One of the things we've seen on the different programs as the different teams here coming through is we've seen veteran players in wheelchair basketball and sports being part of building that next generation on the bench for Nova Scotia's Ross Sampson, who was a track athlete and basketball player back in the 80s. At one point, he's racing against the great Andre Vigée.
Oh, wow.
Legendary track athlete in wheelchair sports in Canada. So it's great to see those veterans coming back and giving back to this generation and really sharing their experiences and giving so that these kids can have the same kinds of opportunities and even better opportunities than they had. I think that's one of the great strengths of wheelchair basketball and Paralympic sport is the understanding by veteran athletes and retired athletes how important it is for them to give back so the next generation has an opportunity.
Sampson picks the pass off. Too strong. He's hounding Beth Johnson in the backcourt for it. It'll be a foul.
Foul on Jack Sampson.
Tough one. That's one of those ones where, you know, we always want players to play maybe a little bit, not conservative, but make the percentage decision. Mm. And instead of going up and challenging that rebound, getting back so he can be back there in the center of his defense, linked to his teammates. It can be so tempting there when you see that ball kind of right out in front of you and you just want to go get it.
Johnson's put back off.
Yeah, D. Osmond did a great job sprinting out wide to create space right off the rebound, so there's an outlet for Liam Murray to pass to and move that ball up the court.
Osmond will control. Bernard's third foul. Jason Dross will get a chance to shoot a couple free throws. First one up, just off.
So right now for both teams, all five Manitoba players that are on the court will be returning for the next Canada Games, and three of the Nova Scotia players will return. So a lot of players out there getting some valuable minutes down the stretch here.
Johnson with the board, leads out Thévenot, makes the catch. Got caught in there, couldn't make the grab.
I really like how Liam Murray is going to space to move that ball and then be a post for the ball. So he's thinking about how he can facilitate ball movement.
And shot clock violation.
So Liam Murray, one of the young players that will be returning that next quad for the next Canada Games for Nova Scotia.
Johnson zips down low, has a look, can't make it. Back comes Osman. Inside, Drost. No good. And now Teo Ra on a breakaway. Let's see if Teo can get himself on the board. Settles down, shot, gets the roll. His dad will be dancing for that one.
There he is. He's beating the drum up in the stands. I thought Teo hustled, get the ball, but then didn't panic. Got himself set. Good balance and alignment on that layup.
Drost blocked.
It's a nice cut by Jason to get into the key against the shorter Ryan Long Sox Bolesky. He wants to keep that ball up high.
Oh, there it is. Long Sox. Second free throw short.
Nice pick by D. Osmond to help Jason Drost get in on defense so they can have all five back and start from a stronger position, fill some of those gaps.
Devino, a quick spin move. Nice attack into the lane. A little aggression here from Thomas. Osmond took an elbow to the back of the head there.
Yeah, we've seen Thomas do a great job on ball, creating space, and then attacking the back of the defender.
So Osmond will get a couple free throws out of it. First one off to the right.
Yeah, Thomas showing no fear, and I think that's because his parents at Halloween put on a huge haunted house, and people come from all around and pay to go through their haunted house and festivities and facilities and stuff like that. So I think they've gotten all the fear out of Thomas. That's why he attacks the basket the way he does.
It's in his blood. So last possession here. Cross to Rossello. Over to Long Sox. Shot up. Just short. Bernard the save. And he's out of bounds. So that will just about wrap this one up. Manitoba finishing out their tournament with a split day, a nice showing here in Nova Scotia. One of the more developmentally focused groups, but they can look back on this as a reflection point and improve from here.
Yeah, so again, as we've talked about, so Manitoba, this is a program that's building for the next quad, and they've gotten a lot of quality repetitions, quality minutes on the court, and we've seen their team grow and learn as the tournament's gone on. Nova Scotia, tougher battle, but they still return four athletes that'll come back and will benefit from this experience that they've got. So for both of these programs now, it's about going back, setting the plan, learning from this experience, and setting the plan for the next 4 years. Waiting in the wings, you can see Quebec and New Brunswick sitting there just chomping at the bit. Rematch from earlier on in the tournament.
Yeah, so that was a great game in the round robin. We have that one coming up at the top of the clock, 5 p.m. local, 7 o'clock Eastern Quebec, and New Brunswick will be back with you then.